Good evening and welcome to Village of Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, November 4th, 2020 at 6 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee Griffin? Trustee Aguirre?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Palmiter, will you lead us in the pledge?
Thank you, Mayor. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. Our long agenda this evening, ordinance 2016-62, ordinance amending chapter 43 of the Village Code ordinances, fee schedule, Department of Community Development. Mr. Rich Vogel, would you like to speak on this tonight?
Thank you, Your Honor. It'd be my pleasure. I think everybody's obviously aware of all the impacts that the COVID health emergency has had on business communities across this country. Ours is no exception. And in particular, I think our restaurant and bar, the food service segment of our local economy, has been hit, probably doubly hard compared to everybody else. This is some relief to help those folks keep doing what they're doing, and it will waive the otherwise applicable business licensing fees for restaurant bar type businesses with food service for the year 2021.
Very good. Any questions or comments? Another way to try and help them out, keep our folks hopefully open.
Yep.
I know they're doing everything they can, and I've got to speak to quite a few of them directly myself and stop by their places and talk to them, and hopefully we will keep these folks going and figure out creative ways. And I know, I better watch it. I keep ordering from them. I'm going to put on another couple of COVID pounds, but I strongly encourage everybody to go out there and support these great establishments that have been a part of our community and continue to be a part of our community. So if there's no other questions or comments, great. I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion second. By Trustee Clancy. Second by, I'm going to give it to Trustee Palmiter.
Okay.
And any other discussion? Hearing none, can I, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Nays, the ayes have it. We are adjourned for 7 minutes. Did I drop one of these over there for you, Lou? Welcome back. We have the Village of Romeoville's regular meeting this Wednesday, November 4th, 2020 at 6:10 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee Griffin? Trustee Aguirre?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Trustee Palmiter, will you lead us in the pledge again?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Petitions from the public, we have none. Motion for consent agenda.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Palmiter.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda then, we have minutes 20-08-18, approval of minutes October 21st, 2020 workshop meeting. Minutes 20-08-19, approval of minutes 2021, October 21st, 2020 regular meeting. 20-27-97, approve bill schedule A. 20-27-98, approve bill schedule B. 20-27-99, approve bill schedule C. Ordinance 2016-61, ordinance adopting an amended section 36.48 of Village Code ordinances. Resolution 2030-16, resolution authorizing the waiving of the bids and installing of a light pole and security camera conduit at Conservation Park and accepting a proposal for the same for Georgia Landscaping Inc. And resolution 2030-17, a resolution authorizing execution of a release and waiver agreement with Stephen J. Golden. Motion?
Motion to approve.
Motion approved by Trustee Palmiter. Second by Trustee Richards. Very good. Further discussion? Hearing none. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Mayor's report. Well, first of all, that, yeah, Steve, we will be talking much over the next few weeks about, you know, and really, you know, the wonderful group of people we've had retire this last year, and you, of course, being at the top of that and helping us put in place the people that will succeed, a lot of them, and just how much of a pleasure and how lucky we are to have had you doing all that. So, but we're going to have some more time to talk about all that. So thankfully, we have a little time, and you're not running away anywhere, so we can talk about that at length. and we had some other people retire in their last days recently. We started planning that quite a bit of time ago, and obviously it all kind of an interesting time with COVID and everything. And I hope once we get beyond all this too, we have an opportunity maybe to bring people back and do maybe a bigger celebration with all of them, and the way we'd always like to. We also had an interesting day yesterday. Well, actually, I should say a few weeks. With the election, and I just want to, you know, commend everyone who put their name on the ballot and went out there and was a part of the process or volunteered, or, you know, to everyone, winners and losers. You know, we just want to thank them for everything they did as part of the process. As modern elections have become, it takes a little time to get the final results in some races. I don't think we need to get any more into that, but we will get there, I assure you, in one direction or the other, and it will all be good. And our country will come together, and we will continue to move forward. It's a long process, going through and seeing the lines here for early voting and other places. I mean, there were lines everywhere throughout the country, really. What was the final total we ended up having here, Candy? Do you remember?
Over 3,472.
That's a lot of voters. just to give you an idea, that's like a lot. I mean, we wouldn't even, yeah, honestly, that's just a lot. And I really want to commend Candy and helping coordinate with the clerk's office and the team that we were able to bring in and help out here on site for all the hours they put in and going above and beyond to what is really just a tremendous amount of early voting. And I know that the residents who were able to take advantage of it here at this site, we're one of only a very small number of municipalities that do this anymore. Quite a few have actually passed on doing it anymore because it is an additional service that was never originally intended, as elections have progressed, that became something new. So we're one of the few that continue to make that available to our residents, and we're fortunate to have such talented people to do it. Talking about big things and big events and great people working and volunteering, I really just have to say thank you to everyone who came out and everybody who volunteered or worked at our Halloween event. Huge lines, but that's because there's not much else to do. And, it took a little while for us to get through, but, I want to thank those people who stood out there in the cold and spent that extra time helping out, because I know for me, seeing the families that came through, and Linda and I were up front with Dave and some others, as each and every single car came through, and when you hear a parent tell you this is the only thing that their kid is going to get to do this season, and how heartfelt they are about this being just that little bit of normalcy, it's well worth it. There's really, honestly, and I hope that we never have to do in that format again, and hopefully we won't. But we tried, and we didn't let it stop us, and which has really been the theme of this year for everybody here and all our staff who do a wonderful job and put creativity into these things in their hearts, is not letting it stop you, at least trying to do it. And and so hopefully in the future we don't have to do it in that format, but I really want to thank everybody who tried to do it in that format and didn't just give up. So, you know, you look at the I think there were two moms that posted about their, you know, their autistic children who, you know, really weathered it fantastic. And how, you know, and the other parents who talked about their dance parties in their cars and how that memory, they'll keep that memory. They'll keep the memory, and the kid will remember that I just got this, it was this amazing amount of candy. And knowing that we were able to touch at least some of these, we would have loved to have gotten everybody, trust me. After twice as long, we had to let some of these people go for the night before they froze. I'm glad we were able to get in touch with those lives and give that little bit to them. So, but I also want to thank SRA. I went out and got to be a part of their. For those who are not familiar, SRA is the Special Rec District Association that we have and housed here in Romeoville, but encompasses a number of different jurisdictions. And they held a special format Halloween event as well, and it was just fantastic. Very safe, very creative, and they just did a wonderful job. And you know, I also want to say on the various people who participate in Halloween, no matter how you chose to participate, not participate to your own comfort level, just thank you for being a part of it. And those who needed to be safe, that's okay too. I tried to do my best to create a little candy chute and have fun with it at the same time and be creative. And one little special boy who just got the greatest joy in the world is seeing candy go down a candy chute. You know what? It was well worth the time and effort just to see that one kid smile in this, especially in this year. And so a lot of kids, a lot of families. It was a beautiful day. However you decided to enjoy it, I hope you enjoyed it. And you know what? We got more to do. There's more coming. We got the Winter Light Festival. And you know what? Here's what I'm going to tell you. We're going to get through this. You know, I think we're starting to get to the point where we're further into it and along into it than we are. There's more behind us than there is ahead of us, hopefully. But what I can tell you is that we have great people here working for you, volunteering, and a part of our community to make this happen and keep us moving through it. We'll do it together. So I just want to thank everybody that's a part of that, from every department, every employee, every volunteer, and every person who's involved, and every organization, every business. How much do you all very much mean to us all? So with that, I'll stop talking for this evening, since I already doubled the amount of time, and turn over clerk's report.
No report.
Very good. I think we'll pass on citizen commission liaison reports. If there's anything necessary, you can probably say it during your comments. Village manager's report.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you for, I'll have some really great words coming up. Just not quite ready for them right now, but thank you for the kind words. I really appreciate it. It means a lot, and a lot of memories. You know, awesome. A couple shout outs. One to the mayor for his cool candy shoot. Mayor sent me a picture of it Friday night. I think we were at 11:30 at night. He was working on it and putting a final coat of paint on it. And he sent me pictures, and I'm up, and he's up, and so it was pretty cool.
Working on other things too, but
yeah, seeing that. So great job, and it was pretty cool, really, very inventive. Shout out to all those who voted. Record turnouts. I think that's awesome that people took the time to either early vote or come to the polls, especially during a pandemic. And that's just congratulations to all the people that did that. And Candy is moving to the PD, and so she has volunteered her time to come over an early vote anytime, is what you said, right?
Maybe not after that. Before that.
All I know is Friday at 7:30, she texts me, "I finally got out of here, and this, I'm not doing this again." So thanks, Candy. That's all I have.
Very good. Yeah, they really just an outstanding team. I know that the lines weren't unique to here. They were really everywhere. And I know every early polling location set records, but we have very, very good people, very professional to make sure it gets done and done right and safely. And again, it's another thing that, you know, we hope we never have to do it that way again. But we did, and we got it done, and we're all still here, and we'll keep moving forward. So thank you to everybody that did that. So with that, we have new business. We have ordinance 2016-62, ordinance amending Chapter 43 of the Village Code Ordinances, Fee Schedule, Department of Community Development.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Chavez.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Palmiter.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Board comments. Trustee Chavez.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. All right, boy, it's been a while since I've been up here traveling for business. But I'm only going to stick to the local stuff today. I'll save my goodbyes to my buddy Steve here for next meeting. But one thing I want to say is many thanks to all those that came out to vote today, or this week, I'm sorry. And record turnouts, I saw it for the first time. You know, I always went at 6 o'clock in the morning, and it was the first time I seen there to be at least 50 people there before the doors opened. I was shocked. I'd never seen that before. So that was nice to see. And I just want to say many thanks to all the voters, all the residents that came out. That's the way it should be. Other thing I noticed, too, when I was in there in line waiting to vote, it was good to see new young blood volunteering work in the polls, which is good, and I thank them. And because it's always the same people, right, every year for the last 30-plus mm-hmm. years. And now I was able to see some young guys, and I was real happy to see that. So I want to say thanks to all those, like the mayor mentioned, all those that volunteered. You know, I just want to reiterate that, and I actually witnessed it in my polling place. So many thanks to all those that are helping out. a lot of good things have been happening. I heard a lot about the Halloween Fest. Read about it, heard about it from residents. They loved it, and I'm just real glad that we're able to continue to do that as a municipality, organizations and get-togethers like that for our residents to bring joy and happiness to the kids. It's all about the kids, so I support that 100%. The other thing I want to mention is what we passed today is that we're trying to help out. We know it's tough, and I just want to thank everybody that agreed to waive the license fee for 2021. You know, that we're doing as much as we can. I mean, we're feeling it too, but we feel comfortable in our budget that we can allow us to do this. And I just want to say thanks to everybody who dug into this and implementing this relief for our restaurants and bars for 2021. I'm really happy that we're able to do that. And then, of course, I wanted to remind the business owners that while I was gone, the village board passed the second grant program for local restaurants. So please take the opportunity, look it up, fill out the paperwork. Hopefully you qualify, and anything we can do to help our local restaurants, you know, they're doing a great job now. I'm helping out as much as I can, and it's just great to see them here. Actually, this COVID isn't really working out well on the diet, I'll tell you that.
I hear you, buddy. Between Halloween and Halloween and ordering to support people.
That's all I have, Mayor. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Trustee Palmer, please.
Thank you, Mayor. Jill pretty much covered everything. Once again, the Halloween drive-through was perfect. I think the residents really enjoyed it. They were very gracious because of the waiting times. They would still come up and, you know, like Jen said, we were at the front of the line, and I don't think anybody complained about that when they came up. They thanked us for being out there in that cold weather. The kids loved it. Just kudos to our rec center, once again, for coming up with something creative to try and keep people as normal as possible, things to entertain their families. Congratulations to those that won yesterday, and thank you to those that lost, but took the time to throw their hat in the ring. Very proud of the amount of voters that we had this year. It's pretty amazing. I would like to see that for every election. But that's pretty much all I have. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Clancy.
Thank you. And I know it's going to sound a little repetitive, but thank you for all those people getting out and voting. That actually means that you really care not only for the city but the country you live in. And thanks for all the Halloween visitors that came out that night. It was tremendous, and I think it's a great thing that we're doing for the local restaurants to help them out, which helps us out eventually. And also, I know we can repeat this later, but come celebrate the holiday seasons with the Village of Romeoville at Village Hall with the warm glow of lights and many interactive displays, and that'll be set up for December 4th through January 15th along Grand Avenue. So more to follow later. And also, bingo is back. So if you feel lucky, play bingo with the seniors every Tuesday from 10 to 12 to play. Bring your change, each card is 5 cents, and come out and enjoy and have more fun playing bingo. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richard.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So yeah, it's a little repetitive because there's not a lot going on in the world either right now, quite honestly. But yes, Steve, a big thank you to you. We'll talk more about you in 2 weeks. Yeah. And then the election, of course, yeah, I'm with Joe. I vote at 6 o'clock every morning. I pulled up at 5:57. And yeah, I was around the corner and down the bend, and it's like, oh my God, I'm normally, if I'm there at 5:57, I'm either first or second every year, not this year. So it was good to see, and yeah, I agree, people need to participate in the process. We get a voice, we get a choice, so it's good to see people make it. Thank you to Candy and everyone here that helped through the early voting. It seemed like, at least from our area, to be a pretty seamless process. So I'm you know, Lauren Staley and her group with the Will County Clerk's Office, I didn't hear of a lot of complaints around here. There were a couple of ballot box issues, but they were minor and things kept rolling, so that was good. Whether you came out on the side of this you wanted to or your candidate did, it's all part of the process. Congratulations to those that won. Those that didn't, you know, again, you were part of the process, and that's a good thing. And stay part of the process. That's the other piece that needs to happen. Halloween Fest, yeah, 4 hours later, I got to admit, I got a little hangry partway through because, the rec staff, and I mean, like, building department, I think just about everybody was represented there. We had a lot of staff out working that day and handing out candy. It really was amazing because if I was sitting in a car that long, I don't know I would have stayed personally. Of course, if I had my little kid with me, maybe I would have, because we all know we've done those things for our kids before. But when you look at people and you go, I'm sorry the line was so long, and they go, no, thank you for being here. You guys have been standing here for hours handing out candy. Thank you for doing this. That's what it's all about, and that made it all worthwhile. To get home late was well worth it, because a whole lot of kids had a whole lot of fun and got a little bit of normalcy back. So thank you to everyone that participated in that, whether you were working that night, whether you were one of the families that came through. Hope it made your day a little brighter. It did mine. That's all I have.
Some of those families were really inventive. They got Uber Eats to the car. I mean, I wish we had thought about that.
Oh, yeah.
Trustee Geary, please.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. I'm going to start out with the Halloween Fest first. It was great being out there in the freezing cold. It took me 50 flip-flops to look for my boots. It's like, who turned off the heat? And the families were happy, you know, joyous that the kids were getting their candy. They got to dress up, and some of the cars that were decorated were interesting. And thanks to all of our village departments for participating in it, Public Works, the Police Department, Fire Department, everybody was happy being out there, and it was a long time, but I did escape it after 4 hours. But and I got a little the last of the chili at Culver's. So, and again, with our election yesterday, first of all, great thanks to our municipality for having early voting. I thought that was a huge way that we all have a voice. We all have a chance to participate, and we're not limited. So that was great with the mail-in voting, the request for those ballots. I thought that was excellent for people who couldn't get out. I know my brother is a compromised person, so it was nice that he got to vote from home. So we had to think of those people. And like Dave said, you know, congratulations to all the winners in our state and our country. And God bless America. That's all I have. And Steve, we'll talk later too. I'm not going to say we're going to miss you yet.
Very good.
Thank you.
No executive session. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Geary. Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays? The ayes have it.